said this, you know, you said this, I read this from you, is that you talked about this notion of like the conventional happiness formula is wrong. Mm-hmm. What do you mean by that?
So there's this formula for happiness that we've all grown up with and been led to believe is the true path. And that path is, you know, to go to college and get a degree. Mm-hmm. And hopefully you choose a job where you make a lot of money. And then you get that job and you climb the corporate ladder, or you work harder and you put more hours in so you get the recognition so you can get a promotion, or you can buy the 5,000 square foot home, or you can have the brand new, you know, SUV. And so you work hard, you put your head to the grindstone, you work your way up the ladder, you hopefully you create more wealth, and with more wealth, you get more things in your life. And then at the other end of that formula, you finally have arrived at success, right? You've gotten married, you've had the 2.5 kids, you've got the dog, you've got the nice home, you've got the nice car. And so that's the formula that we've all been fed. What we know from the last 10 to 15 years of research, straight out of Harvard University, Sean Aker's work, as well as the University of Pennsylvania with Martin Seligman, is that that formula is actually completely backwards. We actually know that when you put your well-being at the forefront, you change every single business, education, and organizational outcome. And here's why, George. When you're talking about you're talking about a brain, right? So we know that a positive brain is 31% more productive than a brain at negative, neutral, or stressed. And this comes straight from Sean Aker. So when we're thinking about, you know, you're wanting your people to be open-minded and ready to come up with creative solutions to their problems and expand their awareness of how they can use technology. But if the people within the building, if their brains are mostly at negative, neutral, or stressed, they're losing productivity. You know, we also know that a positive brain is going to be 3 times more creative, which means it's going to be able to come up with solutions that it previously couldn't come up with because it was so overrun with the stress and the negativity. We know that a positive brain is 10 times more engaged in their job and in their life. And so this is kind of why happiness and well-being are coming to the forefront, because Fortune 500 companies and even a lot of schools that I work with now, they're seeing the research that says, hey, when I put my employee well-being at the forefront, I actually get better, more engaged, more motivated, more open-minded, more solution-oriented employees who are showing up for work and for kids, and they feel a lot better, not just in their work life, but in their home life.